Hello everybody. In this video, we will discuss how to manage a case of intrusion. In case you want to check out the management of any other type of traumatic injury, you can see in the description box below, the links have been given. So now we'll go ahead with our lecture. Intrusion occurs as a result of an acute impact causing the tooth to be pushed inside the socket. Now, due to this, there is extensive damage to the pulp and the periodontal ligament. The clinical presentation is that of a tooth pushed into the alveolar socket. Now, if you look at this clinical picture, you will observe that it becomes difficult to differentiate whether the teeth are intruded or they are semi-erupted. Now, you look at this blue arrow. It gives the level of the original cemento-enamel junction of the tooth. The red arrow indicates the new level lying within the alveolar bone, and you can observe the difference of how much the tooth has got pushed into its socket. Now, if we try and move such a tooth, we will observe that this tooth is totally immobile because it gets locked in the alveolar bone. Now, when we percuss this tooth, we will hear high ankylotic sound indicating that the tooth is ankylosed within its socket. And if we conduct pulp test, you will observe a negative response indicating that the neurovascular tissues have got damaged. The treatment principles for intruded permanent incisors are entirely dependent upon the stage of root development, whether the root is mature or it is immature. We will first discuss the treatment of teeth with immature root formation. I will explain with the help of a case. Now, this is a case of a 7-year-old girl immediately after injury. You can see in the photograph, the clinical picture reveals that both the central incisors, they have got apically impacted or intruded. Now, the radiographic picture, it reveals that the apex of both the central incisors is immature or it is open. Now, in such a case, what we do is we do not do any treatment and we hope for spontaneous re-eruption. And in most cases, this definitely occurs. Now, during the process of this spontaneous re-eruption, the crushed cervical bone usually gets repaired. Now, after waiting for some time, let us see what happens. Spontaneous re-eruption can occur over a period of several months. Now, this is a picture after 6 weeks. Observe the level of the incisor ledge and compare it with the original level, which was somewhere here. So the teeth have started erupting. Now the picture after 1 year is something like this. The incisal edge level is very nice and it is the way it should be. So that means the teeth have got fully erupted. Now during the period of this spontaneous re-eruption, it is very important that the pulpal status is continuously monitored. In case any periapical radiolucency or inflammatory root resorption develops, which can be observed in the radiograph, it becomes very important that the root canal treatment is performed. And this root canal is then filled with calcium hydroxide paste. Now, this is important because pulpal necrosis is one of the most common complications in an intrusion case. And this does not really concern much with the level of the root development. So it can very commonly and very easily occur. Coming to the treatment of teeth with mature root formation, I'll explain with help of a case of intrusion of a 22-year-old woman. Now this is the tooth involved which showed intrusion after an acute impact in this direction, apical direction. Here is a radiographic presentation of the case. Now, the first step is to cover the exposed dentin of the involved tooth and the adjacent tooth with hard-setting calcium hydroxide. In case of completed root development, spontaneous re-eruption of the tooth is unpredictable. Therefore, orthodontic extrusion is indicated in such cases. The first step is placing the orthodontic wire. For this purpose, 0.5 mm thick orthodontic wire is taken. It is cut to the length such that it includes two adjacent teeth on either side of the intruded incisor. This wire is then bent to follow the curvature of the dental arc and it is attached to the teeth with help of acid etch and composite. The next step is placing orthodontic bracket. An orthodontic bracket is taken and placed on the labial surface of the intruded incisor. Now, in the area where elastic traction is to be exerted, a coil spring is placed in order to prevent slippage of the elastic. Extrusion is initiated by activating elastic traction. The direction of traction should be such that the tooth moves out purely in the axial direction. After about 10 days, you can see that the tooth begins to loosen and it starts moving out. However, if after 10 days no movement is observed, then local anesthetic is administered. This tooth is slightly loosened with help of a forceps and the extrusion with orthodontic process is continued. This is a picture after 2 to 3 weeks. The involved tooth has moved down considerably as the process of extrusion is continuing. Now, at this stage, it is important that the root canal treatment is started. For this, access cavity is made in the involved tooth. The pulp is extirpated from the canal and the canal is filled up with calcium hydroxide paste. After about 4 weeks, it is observed that the intruded tooth gets extruded to its original position. Now, the tooth is maintained in this position for 2 to 4 weeks, after which the orthodontic appliance can be removed. Now, if you observe in the x-ray, it can be seen that the cemento-enamel junction of the involved tooth is comparable or at the same level with that of the adjacent teeth. Now, the fractured crowns, they are restored with help of composite resins to give them a nice anatomy and a good aesthetic appearance. Now, the follow-up procedures for this kind of trauma is continuous clinical and radiographic monitoring to check for any signs of resorption, root resorption, or ankylosis. Well, the general prognosis for such teeth is that there is high risk of root resorption. Then only teeth with immature root formation have shown to demonstrate pulp survival, and in mature teeth 100% pulp necrosis occurs. Also, some teeth have shown ankylosis as late as 5 years following injury. Therefore, these teeth require extended follow-up periods. These are the references with help of which this presentation was made. I hope you enjoyed your lecture. Do subscribe to this channel to support it and to receive continuous updates. Also, check out other videos on trauma, the links of which have been given in the description box below. And there are videos on dental caries and on occlusion, which you should not be missing. Thank you.